that's the way you get yourself off. And now when you're going to go have sex with your girl or something, you don't find that you're as aroused. This is another comment, which I think, like, because I think a lot of guys can relate to this, and this even happened to me when I was trying to, because, like, for me, I told you guys, I was watching porn from 11 to 24. When I was 16, 17, I kind of understood how it was affecting me. Like, I got on the NoFap forums and all that, and I was like, damn, like, it is messing with how I look at women. It is messing with, like, a bunch of things. So it just took me a long time to quit because I had to build better habits, had to get rid of triggers. But this guy mentioned something. He said, I'll just say that when I was a young man, watching adult entertainment had a serious impact on my sexual performance and relationships with my girlfriend. I'd have trouble getting an erection, keeping an erection, or sometimes I'd even have trouble finishing. And I was only 23 years old at the time. After realizing that I was hurting myself and my relationship with my significant other, I did a 2-week detox, no adult entertainment and no fapping. Doing that fixed those problems immediately. My relationship with my girl was better, the sex was way better, and best of all, I ended up loving and respecting my girlfriend even more. I can't stress enough how horrible and how destructive adult content can be for men's mental and emotional health, regardless of their age. That shit happened to me when I was in my relationship with my first girl that I had for 4 years. There was a period of time where I was like, the fuck, what's wrong with my dick? But the problem I was having, it's called porn-induced erectile dysfunction. Because you build the habit loop of having the cue of whether, like, sometimes you're bored or sometimes you're lonely, so you watch some porn, you watch a few different videos. That's the way you get yourself off. And now when you're going to go have sex with your girl or something, you don't find that you're as aroused. A few reasons, but one of those reasons being because you see this hyper-stimulus of different women in porn, and then you try to come and have some vanilla sex with your girl, and it's not as stimulating. So you imagine, as a young, I was young and healthy. I wasn't, you know, but as a young, healthy dude, my dick's not getting hard. What the, I realized, like, shit, this is because of porn. Like, it's a real thing. If you go on the forums and type in porn-induced erectile dysfunction, thousands of stories of dudes that are like, yeah, I experienced this when I was 20-something. I quit. I was able to get off. And boom, everything is so much better.
Yeah, and to try to figure out, like, what the answer is, it's not really clear on what the answer is for each individual person. But what I think is a good idea is just to examine and just think about, like, how often do you watch it? You know, how into it are you? How many different things did you have to get through to get to the point you're at now? Like, have you gone through, like, hundreds and thousands of videos of porn to find out that you like this specific type of porn and that you know a lot of the names of, like, the porn stars and shit like that? I mean, you might be you might be in a little bit, you know, over your head, and there might be, you know, something to just think about and consider on how you can work your way out of it.
Yeah, it's really fucking crazy. And I think there's an interesting thing, you know, like, one question that a lot of guys have is exactly, like, if I'm not watching porn, then how am I supposed to deal with stress? Like, if I'm sexually frustrated, right? But again, number one, if you've been like I was, if you were so used to using porn as, like, when you were horny, just watch a quick video, get yourself off, go do the other shit you got to do because you can't focus, right? If that is the way that you are used to de-stressing or being able to focus on other things, you need to give yourself time to learn how to use your imagination. Because if the easiest way for you to get off is by watching porn, you're going to find it impossible to use your imagination or even to use pictures, right, to do that. Because it's not as stimulating. Again, think about this. There is no other time in history where, like, we were able to see so many images of naked women, etc., than now. Even before the age of the internet, where there's magazines and VHS tapes, still doesn't compare to what we have now. Because now, you go to any website, you can get literally anything you want, thousands of videos, as many types of, like, it's too much for us to handle without us affecting us negatively. So there's nothing wrong with masturbation, but you need to get yourself to a point where you're able to get yourself off of porn. We can talk about how you can do that. And then if you do get horny, like, real talk, I think one of the reasons why I was able to quit successfully is because I had so many physical habits that tired me out that honestly, by the end of the day, even if I was horny, like, and I was trying to fight against watching porn, I've done so much that I don't even want to.
Right.
You know what I mean? And if you have so much energy to do things, and you have, if you find yourself, because I'll be real here, I found myself in a place where, if I was, I would have certain triggers. So if I was like kind of bored and I was alone on my computer, or it was late at night and I was, you know, I couldn't sleep, because I would be like, oh, I can't sleep, let me just bust out a video. There would be certain cues like, oh, you're bored, you're lonely, you can't sleep, pull up a quick video. That'll, I built these habit loops that I had to figure out a way to figure out my triggers and figure out other routines so I could actually quit. But if you put yourself in the same situations that you always found yourself watching porn, you're going to continue doing that. If you don't figure out what those triggers are for you, if you don't figure out what those routines and those loops are, you're going to keep doing the same thing, and it's going to be fucking difficult to quit.
We've all heard that to get optimal sleep, you should cool your room down to 68 to 69 degrees. But that's not all you need to do, and that's why we've partnered with 8 Sleep mattresses. Now, they have the Pod Pro and the Pod Pro cover, and the amazing technology of this mattress allows you to cool the mattress down to 55 degrees or to have it as warm as 110 degrees. But the great thing is that the temperature changes through the night based off your actual body temperature to make sure that you get the most restful sleep possible. You fall asleep 32% faster, and you move around 40% less when you're actually asleep. It's amazing. And Andrew, how can people get it?
Yeah, this is amazing technology that actually changes its temperature based off of your sleep cycle. There's no other technology like it anywhere else. To take advantage of this, head over to 8sleep.com/powerproject. That's E-I-G-H-T sleep.com/powerproject. And you guys will receive $150 off this amazing technology. Links to them down in the description below. Let's get back to this video.
Another option would be to, like, if you can't beat them, join them kind of thing. Watch some porn with your partner and explain to them some of the different stuff that you like, that you're into. Like, hey, I really enjoy this. I like this a lot. And maybe it just opens up conversation where you can both figure out a way to get comfortable with some of the same things. I don't think that porn is like necessarily bad. I actually think that there's probably a lot of good, might sound funny, but there's probably a lot of like education that comes from porn, and porn has kind of set trends for all kinds of different things, even like with people's pubic hair and stuff mm-hmm. like that. I mean, you know, without porn, we probably wouldn't have all the shaving that we have going on nowadays.
Big old bushes everywhere.
Yeah. Y'all don't like a good bush?
As long as it's not out of control.
A throwback?
Yeah. No.
And down with some hair. Throwback. It's all good.
Yeah. Hey, whatever's going on, you know?
Yeah.
Okay. I feel like this is a place for some healthy disagreement. So I know I have a bias because, number one, I started when I was super young and I saw how it affected me. And just because it affected me negatively doesn't mean it affects everybody negatively. So mm-hmm. I can understand that. But even so, I think this, you know, we were talking before the episode, because of the time that high speed internet started, and a lot of guys ended up like me, I got on at 11, a lot of guys end up getting in at 12, 13, 14, 15, where you are building in certain deep rooted habits, you know, and your brain is super plastic. Like, number one, you shouldn't be able to see people having sex in your teenage years. Like when you're like 15, 16, it's like it's such a stimulus. That's like, it's hard for you not to want to watch that a lot, especially because you're a teenager, you're fucking horny all the time. Like, porn is like, oh, it's candy, right? You can't control the amount of candy you eat at those ages. And because you get all this free candy all the time at your fingertips, you can't necessarily see how it could be negatively affecting you. And now you set in these habits that push into your adulthood. Mm. So, number one, as a teenager, all your other homies are like, this is normal, right? Again, this is a different type of porn. This is high-speed internet porn. All your homies are like, this is normal. You're used to watching it every day, maybe just jacking off just once a day to some different videos or whatever. You don't think it's a big deal. But now as an adult, right, you didn't have that self-control in your youth. It's just something that's normal for you. That can be an extremely rough thing, especially now, like let's say that you finally manage to get yourself into a successful relationship, but you've had the habit of watching so much porn because you did it since you were a kid. As much as it could be somewhat beneficial to share that experience with your partner, it's still something that you're probably overusing because, again, it's not like Playboy. It's not like just a magazine. It's not like a VHS tape where it's like one video. It's a candy store that has all of the candy that you could ever want. And now you need to try to get yourself to back off from that. Mm-hmm. And it causes so many different types. It might be a
gateway type of thing to, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. But here's the different thing. I think this is the different of the viewpoint between myself and yourself. I was part of the generation that was the testers of high-speed internet porn. You know, I got the internet in fucking 2006, 2007, right? You got high-speed stuff later. Like when you're like, but you even mentioned like you got VHS tapes when you're like 18. Mm-hmm. But when did you get high-speed internet porn?
Yeah, it wasn't until probably around the time that you got it.
Exactly.
But I was much older.
You were much older, right? And at that time, that probably doesn't affect your outlook on it as much as it does for individuals in the millennial generation, individuals in Gen Z. We're kind of being brought up with that.
Right.
And that's very different from, you know, seeing magazines and VHS tapes. And you mentioned something interesting. If you had a VHS tape, you couldn't just watch it anywhere. Yeah, like we have phones, right? You couldn't just watch it anywhere. You had to be like...
Yeah, we only have one VCR player.
Right? You have to be careful with that. But now we can see it whenever, as much as we want, in any type of situation, if we're not feeling good about ourselves, if we're not feeling confident. And the thing is like you now have these habit loops where you're not feeling confident or you're feeling bored or whatever. You set those in. Now, when it comes to the seeking, because number one, like, okay, not everyone has to be in a relationship or whatever, right? But to have the confidence to go out and try to find a girl that you maybe you're interested in or have the confidence to do that, a lot of men lack that confidence because they have an easy out because of porn. Like, they're like, it's not saying that the only reason you seek a partner is just for sex, but sex is awesome.
Right.
So you're doing that, right? But if you're getting this easy out with pornography where you can see any woman you want, and not just any woman, like these women are extremely attractive. You know what I mean? Like porn in a sense is also kind of morphed the way men view attractiveness of women, because you find your kink, the things you're into, whether it's big ass or big old titties. And now you can find that to the highest level with someone with big old fake lips, who's in amazing shape. And you're watching that all the time and masturbating to that all the time.
All that stuff comes from porn. Like the fake tits and the fake lips and the fake butts.
And now you go out and you're like, I'm going to go look for a woman. And let's say that you can't find somebody that looks like that, but you find a nice girl, but she doesn't look like the girls that you've been beating your meat to for years.
Like she's got a big ass, but she doesn't have big tits. Forget it.
Right? Right? Exactly. It puts these...
Meanwhile, the dude just looks like a fucking turd.
Yeah. I mean, let's be real. Like, as an individual, you probably have a lot of things you could work on too, but your attraction is being formed by these unrealistic videos that you're watching on a daily basis. You got to figure out, how is that morphing my ideas? How is that morphing my motivations? How is that changing the way I even look at women? Mm-hmm. And I noticed that was changing the way I was looking at women. I was like, ooh, this is a beautiful person right in front of me, but she ain't, fuck, what's going on here? Right? Again, I think there's a big difference when one starts young on that versus if you were like 20 or 21 and you got your hands on that, it's easier to kind of not be morphed by it.
What's going to happen when the metaverse hits too? And VR, I mean, you know, we're talking about a different version of it now. And we're talking about like the kind of evolution of, you know, magazines to videos to high speed internet now to this leap of virtual reality. I mean, if it feels like, so if your brain is having a hard time recognizing whether it's true or not, whether it really happened, when we get this in like a virtual world, we saw how shaky we were walking across the turf, thinking that we're on a plank because we had the VR headgear on. what is that stimulus going to be like, and how unrecognizable will that be? I can actually envision it right now that there'll be like breakups over that. Like you did what with who? Like, yeah, it's a virtual.
Did you see the Black Mirror episode with Falcon was Anthony Mackie?
So weird. But yeah,
that shit was going on in there. Something like that.
Yeah. Well, so it's really fucked up. It's just, so
should we ruin? Go ahead.
No, fuck it,
dude. Watch it anyway.
People need to watch it because I'll just whatever. So two buddies, we play video games all the time.
Buddies, men.
Two men. Sorry. Thank you.
Yeah.
They start playing this fighting game. The new system comes out. You put like a thing in your ear and then you're virtually there. So this dude's main character is this big jack dude. This other dude's main character, I think is a chick.
Yeah.
The friend is a chick. Yeah. And then they start fighting. And the next thing you know, like they like hug each other and they start kissing. And he's like, wait, what the fuck, dude? Like, you're a dude. You're in this thing. Meanwhile, Falcon? I forgot his name.
Anthony Mackie.
Papa Doc. He is married. His buddy's single. Then they see each other after and it's like all awkward and shit. But then they keep wanting to go back and see each other's like avatar in this fighting game.
Pretty much fuck each other's avatars. They
go to town on each other. Meanwhile, this dude's wife is like, what the fuck? So like they start getting separated and I won't spoil the end, but like, it's like, whoa, what the fuck just happened? Like this got so weird. But yeah, what you're saying, Mark, is absolutely true because like what you're saying, just with tabs, our brain can't decipher, like, is this real or is this not real?
Yeah.
So with VR, like, we know it looks like a big cartoon, but our brain's like, nah, dude, don't jump off that ledge because you're going to fucking die.
Hey, well, before you go, you got this far. That means that you've enjoyed the heat that we're continuing to bring you. So listen, like the video, comment something down below, we'll reply back, and subscribe to the channel because we continue to bring you the heat. Seriously, do it. Love you. Bye.